So the multiplayer in this game is just amazing, but it doesn't really explain a lot of things, so new player will have problems. So I'll try to make this as simple as possible. The video will have two parts, one about hosting a server and another one which will be longer about, kind of getting your right loadout for your combat suit. Now you have to know a couple of things before you start. This is kind of like a mech. It's not actually a character per se because you have power rating over here. So the more power you have, the more complicated or complex stuff you can put on your suit. For example, power doesn't increase your energy. I think a lot of people will be confused by this. Increased suit power, so not energy. These are your stats over here, and this is your suit power or your mech power if you want to think of it like that. So you either need to put more power cores or remove them in order to make sure you have enough offensive, defensive, and support stuff. Now, this is a very complex build. I mean, it's not complex, it's the way I played in the beta. I'll get to it later. So you have power for the suit, which means how many or how less you can put on the defense, offense, and support. You have the slots for the main gun and the slots for the second gun. As you can see, I increased my slots for the second gun or for the secondary weapon to actually have a rocket launcher over there. Okay, how about hosting a server? This is the problem. The developers didn't think about this, but the mission setup is actually a lot more important than people think. For example, you can choose private friends only public, experience is 100%, and the maps. Never choose anything but the prevent infestation spread. I mean, it's the basic map for the game that was in the beta. The other ones are shorter, and sometimes you'll just, feel bad about playing them. I mean, the snow colony can be good as well, but it's kind of like a 5, 6, 10 waves are easy, and then it becomes very, very rough. So some maps are specifically designed to be harder in the mid game or the late game. Some maps are designed to be kind of like a more balanced difficulty. So if you're playing the game and you're hosting the server, I really recommend you don't go lower than 2 infestation. If you go lower than 2 infestation, basically the game will be very, very easy. Going on 3 or 4 or 5, it can be a trouble, but it can be done. Now, Infestation 2 is kind of like the basic difficulty. You should play on 3 infestation if you are playing with a pretty decent team, or if you're just explaining stuff. And again, it also depends on the map, because you might get a map where you just have to defend the gates, and if you have to defend the gates, well, even on infestation level 7 or 6, I managed to defend the gates. But some missions with infestation level 2 or 3, it might be too much if you're not careful, just because of the enemy type over here. So look at the enemy type if I change it. As you can see, you can have Lich Nash, which is a bigger behemoth, which will spawn in a certain wave. I mean, it's everything is over here. This is what I like about the game. You have all the numbers. As you can see here, you can't get Lich Nashes. So that's the super behemoths, but you can get zombie marines, which can be worse. And again, you have to select what map you like based on your preference. For example, here, if you stay at wave 12 to 14, this will be terrible for you. Also, signatory mission should always be set on many. Air support should, again, this doesn't modify the amount of experience you get. This modifies it. So if you're set on infestation 2 or 3, you might think it's not a big number, but again, you need I don't want to say millions of experience. You need so much experience to advance in rank to make a perfect build. I mean, at about level 81, you have enough points to actually complete a single build from start to finish. So yeah, be careful of that. Artillery support, I recommend you just put it on none, because it actually decreases the amount of experience you get, and it only decreases the enemy health by a little. I mean, this is only a big thing for the elite one, so I don't know, I recommend you put it at light, at least at light, or if not at zero, because that's 10% extra experience you'll get, and that's actually a big boost. And besides, you're supposed to fight as a team, so yeah, be careful. So this is kind of like the basic stats for the difficulty. Also, you have over here your flyer types and whatever. So changing the difficulty only changes the amount of enemies you'll find. I mean, you'll get more elites, in short. So for example, playing on easy means 15% dogs. On Nightmare, 20% dogs, but again, that's for the first waves only. I mean, it's hard, very hard to discern and read about all of this. But for example, the final wave, you will get, let's see, this is kind of like the basic ones. The elite ones are not really shown over here, their spawn rate. 21 dogs. 31 dogs. That means the spawning tables have more room to get more elites out on the field, so yeah, be careful. Playing on normal or on hard is basically the same thing. Playing on easy, it's too easy in my opinion. Also, you get less experience. So normal or hard. So kind of like a basic setup for a mission with 8 people that kind of know what they're doing is this experience 125%. So this is why people are not advancing in level very fast, because they're playing the shorter maps, which can be very, very short, and you'll get 4,000 points or 2,000 points, which is nothing. They're playing on infestation level 1 or 2, or sometimes 3, but that's very, very rare. And they're also playing with this strat. I mean, you have a lot of... you have too many resources on heavier support. You should put it on light, always on light. Or even better, on none. That means you have to search a lot of lockers, and kind of like this is the preferred way to play the game, because look at how much experience you are losing if you're just not modifying a simple slider. That doesn't really mean much. I mean, if you're playing on, let's say, Nightmare, you might want to put air support to high. But if not, oh well. Okay, now let's get to the loadouts. Like I said, this is kind of like your mech. So you have primary weapon slots and secondary. Also, I should be careful that... Okay, no one joined me. That's nice, so I don't let people over here think about it. Now, this is the heavy. To unlock a class, you need to level up. In the beginning of the game, you only have the assault. And once you level up a bit, you can also unlock some other weapons. For example, if you want to play with the demolition, well, you're in luck. It's actually a pretty easy and fun way to unlock him. But if you want to play with the heavy like I am right now, you basically need to unlock all of these guns over here, and you also need to go to the autocannon. The autocannon is the one you want. Other than that, the submachine guns, as you can see, the lighter weapons are for the lighter classes. So the heavy classes like the demolition and the heavy use basically a lot of firepower, a lot of explosives, have some skills that gives them ammunition or more boom or more explosions. And the recon classes are mainly energy based damage things. Now the marksman is actually the best class in the game, but you have to know how to play it, and is also the hardest one. Recon is decent, you can have fun with it. And the medic, well, I guess you get the medic by default. The medic is, every team should have at least 2 medics. So if you are playing in 8 people, 2 medics. If you are playing in 4 people, 1 medic. And the rest of them can be anything they want, but the medic is the most important one. And for her, the difficulty is marksman, of course. So if you like to play as a guy that shoots everything, heavy. If you like to play as a guy that blows up everything, again, explosives are very, very dangerous. You can destroy ammunitions, you can destroy a door that should be not destroyed, and so on. Demolition. If you want to play as the guy who basically recons, moves fast all over the map, does a lot of cloak and dagger stuff, does sneaky objectives and does a lot of work in the background, but doesn't really kill much, recon. But again, their skills will be so powerful that you'll be able to kill enemies with just your energy-based skills, not using ammunition. Marksman, I already told enough about him, and we'll get 2 more classes, probably this year. Now, you have selected a class, you have played with the assault a little bit, and you want to unlock another class, and you unlocked it. What else do you need for it? Well, first of all, I'll explain for the heavy guy. You need to go to the heavy or whatever class you choose, for example, and give him some really, really great stuff. For example, the ammunition leak is amazing on the heavy. The battle drone is also amazing because it basically gives you a drone above your head that can destroy or kill a lot of enemies. So be careful with it, because it's kind of like the best way to clear a whole street with it, or you can actually destroy growths alone with it. Pretty fun. Also, this will give you damage and reduced loading time, but also more magazine size. So that means you can put 5 magazines at max level in your gun. That means, what, 170 bullets? That means you'll basically not reload for a long time. Now, after you selected your class components, for example, the recon has drop, cal drop, ship, elpilda, overload, communication. I mean, you can summon artillery, and he has gunships and has a lot of cool things, including the speed mechanism. Also, the medic definitely needs to have this one, a revive. A rescue is super important. Also, you can have harvest, tissue scanner, guardian drone. A lot of other great stuff are for the medic. So medic should be heal and resurrect. So you selected your class, you have unlocked components, you have made kind of your build. Then you should go over here to the upgrade components. For example, you won't have access to them unless you research them. Damage. You can have more damage on your gun. 10% damage and less spread. That's actually pretty good. Power core. More suit power. Two small power cores have 30 power and this one occupies two slots and has 40. So that's 10% extra power to the suit. I don't recommend you invest in plating or in nanoplate or in enhancer or resilience or reload upgrades. I think this is a mistake. You should always invest in the things that will give you more damage. For example, the secondary extender. This is what I use to have the rocket launcher on the heavy. I also have the primary extender. So you can have a bigger gun on your recon or your assault or your, even your medic. Imagine a medic with a big gun that is killing everything. Yeah, that's scary. You can also have speed items on them. Don't worry, you'll go to the loadout and you'll understand better. There are some of the skills over here, let's call them skills, but they're basically like passive traits that will reduce some of the other traits. So be kind of careful, you don't make a very very bad build. Speed is king, damage is king. HP can be good, but really depends on you. So for example, let's unlock life support over here. So again, you have your class unlocked, you have your component unlocked, you have the upgrade components unlocked for a better build. Then you also have the things over here that are actually super useful after you have a lot of points. For example, movement speed, you always have to unlock. This is a permanent bonus for all of your classes, so always unlock them as soon as possible. Damage, 1% speed, 2% damage, kinetic armor is really good. Sight radius, but also resistance. That means you'll not get cut, you'll not get exposed, you'll not get weakened. You won't get so many debuffs from the enemies that might also kill you. Most of the times you'll die in the game because you got bleeding or something else that reduces your health. Also, 5% health doesn't look like much, does it? Well, 25% health, well, that looks like something. It's what? 5% extra health. Same as for the other ones, if you want to only play with the class. Squad implants, well, I'm not sure. I guess these are for only for single player, so I wouldn't invest points in them because your progress is shared to single player. For example, if you play a lot of missions in single player, you'll actually gain points over here, experience points that you can use for a class. Now, we can also do this, for example, if you capture enemies with the traps. Okay, this requires a little more explanation. So, in the loadout screen, you can equip a secondary weapon, right? The secondary weapon can be the frostbite, which will help you catch bigger enemies. For the smaller ones, you don't need a weapon. You have to find the traps while playing on the map. I don't think there is a way to get the traps otherwise. You just have to move around the map until you find them. So if you find the traps and you... Actually, this creature you can just capture by luring them into the trap. You don't need to do anything, so yeah. The smaller ones you can just trap by putting the trap in front of you and they'll fall for it. Otherwise, the faster ones like the dogs and the more dangerous ones, you have to use that gun that freezes them. So now we have 1% damage. You might think, well, that's not a lot of damage, is it? Well, how about 30% extra damage? Yeah, that's a lot of extra damage. As you can see, they have different bonuses, so the more you capture, the more stats for you. It's not only damage, as you can see, it's also energy, health. And I think that's about it. Yeah, there's nothing else. But again, you might want to be careful about this because this is kind of like the end game stuff. And once you get all of this and all of the other bonuses, you'll be basically a Terminator. Now, let's speak about my own build for the heavy. For example, can I get... Okay, let's get... No, I can't get a default one, that's silly. Okay. Leave me alone, game. Actually, I can get one. So this is the default setup for the heavy. Now you may be wondering, why do you need so many revives? I recommend you have at least one revive. And the war damnation is actually not so good because you're wasting your energy on it. So you're better off just calling the drone or using it to get more rocket ammo. Now this is a very good build for the beginning of the game, but it's not so amazing if you think about it. So the more stuff you unlock, you can get to this one. Which is great. Now let me see, I unlocked the life support. which needs only one slot. You also can get the life support, which is level 2, which gives you more health and more regen. As you can see, this needs a lot more power, 50 power, 15 power, 50 power, but it gives you a lot more HP. So should you equip this or not? Well, my opinion is no. As you can see, I kind of maxed out and it's very nice like this. I'm using all my power available. So a little bit of HP regen and health in case I get hit a lot, because I'm the slowest character probably. Also increase speed over time. So actually, let's compare this one to the initial one. 387. 427. As you can see, we also have some passive traits over here. Breaching charge. So not everything is the same for the classes, so also look at their stats, not only their add-ons and their other stuff. Now let me explain why I like to play like this. For example, I have the ammunition link, which basically at level 1 is double the ammunition in your gun, which is definitely what you need in the beginning. In the beginning I take 1 level of rocket ammo, battle drone and wear the ammunition, or actually ammunition link. I need 1 revival, also I have the secondary extender to equip the rocket launcher. And then the rocket ammo to produce rocket ammo. I level this up very, very fast. So that means I get 2 rockets per 1 minute. Which means in 10 minutes I have 20 rockets. Which means, yeah, not a lot of stuff is going to be left alive. Now over here, why did I pick those for the offense? Well, there's not much you can pick for the offense. I would have loved to have another dash or another run, but you can't get it. It's impossible, because all of the support stuff, it's kind of used up by the mandatory skills, as I call them. So yeah, what can you pick over here? You can't activate another active skill. Also, this is a passive one, so no matter how hard I try, I mean, I could remove the critical hit, which will free up 40 power, and then I could put more damage on him. Actually, I can't put more damage because again, it's 50 power. So at some point you just have to say, what do I need? Well, it's a long math, but this is kind of like the max I could get on him. So 20% extra damage with a very low spread, that means he'll hit everything. And life support and power core. Also, here you'll have your colors, the more rank you unlock, the better it will be. By the way, currently the game is stuck, you can't progress further than Command Sergeant. You have your level and your rank. You can be, let's say, Command Sergeant level 200, doesn't matter, you'll get the points. If you level up your rank, I mean if you rank up, I think you get bonus stat points or bonus experience. I'm not sure what you get, but you definitely should level up. Right now, this is the max you can get. This is kind of like the short version of the game. There are so many things to talk about. For example, each class has multiple loadouts. If I get tired of playing the class like this, I can always go for something else. For example, you can play with probably the most destructive gun in the game, with the heavy, which is the Vindicator, but it will be a little tough to play like that. I can also remove most of the support stuff. I can give him more speed, because I can also give him, let's say, agility, which increases his movement speed over here. And just give him the rocket ammo, the secondary extender, and remove the ammunition link and the other stuff. And put a few reloads over here, but again, that's not really how I want to play it. Or you can use this guy as a buff for your entire team, because on the harder difficulties you'll always be together. So give him targeting systems instead of, let's say, critical hit, or instead of the drone, because the drone is not really useful against the bigger enemies. This is only useful when you're playing alone objectives and you want to escape or stuff like that. So battle drone is definitely one of the weakest skills I have right now, so I can replace that with something for the team. Heavy weapon is also nice because it's a passive one, but at the same time, critical bonus I already get from this one. But just in case you want more power to have ammunition and just firing at your enemies. Again, the game is very versatile, and if you never stop at one class, the next class I'll probably unlock will be, well, the medic, I think, because I want to make a medic that can kill a lot of stuff. And I also want to play as a class that is super, super fast, because I'm tired of always falling behind my team. So yeah, for example, imagine putting something like this. I mean, I can have the primary extender on him, but I didn't unlock it yet, so primary extender. So that means I could probably use a light machine gun. Yeah, I can have a medic with a light machine gun. That would be funny, right? Also, you can have them with the SGAR or the ASV, or the Strike as it's called. Or even, I'm not sure how many points, how many slots this occupies, but again, you can just play around with them so much, you won't believe how adaptive this game is. Again, I need to unlock a lot of stuff that is currently not visible over here. So people usually play with free builds and free builds for each class, but again, you probably need 100 or 200 hours to unlock everything and do all of the things that I showed, so... Until then, have a lot of fun with the game and I hope we get more fixes for the game soon. Bye.